Okay. Hello, hello. So today we are going to start with the survival. Already last lecture we have seen what is syllabus for survival for you people this semester. Okay, and we are going to start with the first unit today. And that first unit is a learning. What is learning? Or first thing, what is mean by surveying you people should know. What is surveying? Initially I have taken 4-5 lectures. Okay, before I think you are 60 people are not in. Only 30 or 35 people in this class. That time I have taken 4-5 lectures. In that 2 lectures, initially I have told you what are the career opportunities in civil engineer. Okay, and then I have told the students what about the surveying, what are the principal classification, and what are the technical terms required in the surveying. Okay, so again I am going to repeat the same thing today, and then from next lecture we are going to start with the actually the levy units. So first thing, what is mean by surveying? What is surveying? Why is required in the civil engineering? What is the definition of surveying? So art of determining the relative positions of different points by measuring horizontal distances and vertical distances between them. मतलब simple thing कि दोनों point मतलब horizontal distance and vertical distance measure करना क्या process लगाया मतलब survey. Okay? And the moment where you are going to separate out surveying and leveling. The leveling it is only to take the vertical distances and surveying means measurement of horizontal distances. Measurement of horizontal distances already you have learned in diploma level. Means chain, tape, how to measure the distances that you already studied in diploma level. So for here in your syllabus, first unit is a leveling. Okay? Before going to start with the leveling, you should know the primary knowledge about the surveying. What is the subject surveying? Why we have to study the subject surveying? What is the reason to study the surveying subject? Main objective of surveying to prepare the maps. Means whatever the relative positions of the various object on the ground surface, that position of the object on ground surface you have to show on the map. And those maps are useful for the various civil engineering purposes. And that's why to construction of the dam, to construction of the various bridges, to for construction of a town, for town planning, all purposes, the surveying is required. Okay, so definition, before we see this level, I will review again in survey what are the important things and the various questions you are going to face in oral basic question based upon this. So in survey first, definition of survey, and after definition, objective of survey. After objective, classification of survey, or sorry, use of survey. After classification, principle of survey. These are the various initial things you people should know before going to start with the surveying subject. Definition, the art of determining the relative positions of different points by measuring the horizontal distances and vertical distance between them. What is objective of surveying? The main objective of surveying is to prepare the maps. And what thing you are going to prepare on the map? Neither map of the diagram. Whatever the relative positions of different object on the earth surface, the position of that the object on the earth surface you have to transfer into map. Okay, so that is main objective of the survey. And what is then, if you have the objective, what is use of that objective? Use can next time can what are the uses of survey? So those maps you can use for the various purposes. Means the country plan or natural. What is the things which you want to represent on your country map? Means river, okay? river, road, rail lines, what are the various things if you want to present a geographical structure of the country, in that case you have to prepare the maps. And those maps you can use for doing various purposes. Like there are various purposes, means you can prepare the various kind of maps. Structural maps, country geographical map, geological map, archaeological map, military map. Okay, so you can prepare various kind of maps by using survey, and for various purposes you can use those maps. Means suppose if you are going to, if by doing the survey you are going to prepare the contour maps, those contour maps are useful for the construction of dams, for construction of a reservoir, for construction of a barrier. Likewise, if you want to see the various road or railways or civil engineering maps, in that case if you are going to construct any road, rail lines, in that case also you can refer those maps. Okay, so why you have those maps you can directly use? Because earlier you have done the survey, and because of you have done the survey, those things is useful to construct the various cylindrical structures. Okay, so these are the various uses of surveying. What are the uses? For uses of cylindrical purposes, okay, archaeological, okay, geological, okay. So for these various purposes you can use the surveying. Next is the classification of surveying. So classification of surveying, basically there are two classification. First is the primary and secondary. What is mean by primary surveying classification and secondary? Primary, already I told you. What are the, then you are going to see the various. Primary classification is plain survey, plain and geodetic survey. What is mean by plain survey? As you know, the shape of earth is a square here. Okay, and if you are going to measure the distances on the earth surface as a civil engineer, basic thing, when you are going to measure the distances on the earth surface, earth is spherical shape. Okay, and when you are going to measure the minor distances, means suppose I have to measure the length of this classroom with respect to the perimeter of this earth surface, what is length of this classroom? Is a very negligible. Getting? With respect to the perimeter of earth surface, the length of this classroom is negligible. In this case, suppose if I am going to measure the distance, whether I have to consider the curvature of the earth or not. Because it is compared to the perimeter of the earth surface, it is very negligible. So no need to consider the curvature of earth surface. But when I have to measure the large distances, means suppose I have to measure the distance from Solapur to Mumbai or Solapur to Delhi, in that case that distance is too large, and with compared to the perimeter of earth surface, it is a matter. Okay? If suppose Solapur is here, Delhi is here, here is the curvature, you are going to measure distance like this. But actual distance is a curved distance, so there is a variation. Okay, so if you are going to do survey for the small work, or you are going to measure the distance is small, you are going to work in a small area, that survey is called as a plane survey. Means you are not going to consider the curvature of earth. When you are not going to consider the curvature of such survey is called as a plane survey, and when you are going to consider the curvature of earth, where you are going to measure the larger area. Suppose I have to conduct the survey of Maharashtra state. So Maharashtra state, larger survey than the same, but that case mode kutla survey kar lagel mala geodetic survey. Because with compared to the earth surface, Maharashtra state length or dimension is too large, so I have to consider the curvature effect. And that survey is a geodetic survey. How you are going to decide whether you are going to carry out work as a plane, or you are going to work the survey as a plane survey or geodetic survey, when area is less than 250 km square, area just measure, so that survey is called as a plane survey, and when area is greater than 250 km square, such survey is called as a geodetic survey. Means suppose you want to conduct the survey which having the area of 200 km square, which survey you are going to consider?
Plain survey. And suppose you want to do survey for the area 300 kilometers square, so you are going to use the geodetic survey. Simple thing, in oral examination also, external going to ask a question, what is the various types or classification of the survey primarily? So there are two classification of survey. First is a plain survey and second is a geodetic survey. Plain survey means where you are not going to consider the curvature of earth at the time of doing survey, and geodetic survey means you are going to consider the curvature of earth. And area less than 250 km square, plain survey, greater than 250 km square is a geodetic survey. So this is about the primary classification. Now secondary classification. Secondary classification, it is based upon the what are the various types of instrument you are going to use, what is nature of work, okay, what are the methods and what are the various uses. Based upon these four things, the secondary classification is defined. First is the type of instrument. Second, nature of work. Methods of survey. And fourth is purpose. So first is based upon the type of instrument. Types of instrument means earlier in diploma, you people have used various instruments. Okay, which instrument? Chain you have used? And prismatic compass is your use. When you are going to use a chain for the measurement of the length, okay, or dimensions, such surveying is called as a chain survey. Okay, so depending upon the type of instruments, when you are going to use a chain, such surveying is called as a chain survey. When you are going to use a compass, that surveying is called as a compass survey. When you are going to use theodolite, such surveying is called as a theodolite or theodolite survey. When you are going to use the plane table, that surveying is a plane table survey. When you are going to use the photogrammetry, that is a photogrammetry survey. When you are going to use aircraft or mounted aircraft mounted the camera, such surveying is called as a aerial survey. Okay, so based upon the various types of instrument you are going to use, that based upon that, this is secondary classification. Okay, next is the nature of work. Nature of work means when you want to do survey. Means if you are going to do the survey on the ground, in that case, that is terrestrial survey. When you are going to carry out survey into water, that survey is called as a hydrographic survey. And when you are going to carry out survey into air, that survey is called as a aerial survey. So based upon the nature of work, it is also classified. Next is the methods. This is very important. Methods means already I have told you. What are the methods of survey? Two methods. First is a triangulation and second is a traversing. Okay, what is triangulation and traversing? Triangulation and traversing. What is this triangulation? Already I have told you. What is in the triangulation? Triangulation is the principle of chain surveying. Okay, initially people don't know. Okay, those students are in 30 or 31 student lecture, student are in the lecture, initial lectures. I ask what is principle of the chain survey. And you people should know principle of each and every survey. Means you have to know what is principle of plane table survey, what is principle of a theodolite, what is principle of a dummy table, or what is principle of chain survey, what is principle of compass. Okay, what is triangulation? Basically, triangulation is the principle of chain survey. Chain survey means, in chain survey, which thing you have done? You have measured the area. Initially, you have taken one chain line, like this. And after getting this line, you have find out various objects near to this. Which is the tree asset. You have find out the various locations. And you have taken the various objects also, like this. Like this. Okay, then you are drawing these lines. Okay, and by using various methods, you have calculated this area. How you calculate the area? By dividing this area into number of triangles. And what is triangulation means, the principle of chain survey, the total area you have to divide into number of equal well-conditioned triangles. Okay, and you are going to measure the area. This is the principle of the chain surveying. That is triangulation. Well-conditioned triangle means, already I have told, what is well-conditioned triangle? The triangle in which the minimum angle should not be less than 30 degree and maximum angle should not be greater than 120 degree. Such triangle is called as a well-conditioned triangle. And if any angle less than 30 degree angle, more than 120, such triangle is called as a ill-conditioned triangle. Well-conditioned and ill-conditioned triangle. In triangulation, always you are going to use the well-conditioned triangle. Next method is a traversing. Traversing means what? Traversing means what? You have to form a traverse. And after forming the traverse, you are going to measure the area. How you are going to form the traverse? How you are going to form the traverse? By measuring the angles. Initially, you people should know what is meant by traverse. What is traverse? A series of connected lines is called as a traverse. The series of connected lines is a semicircular. A series of connected lines is a traverse. A series of connected lines is a traverse. Okay? Such types of traverse is a closed traverse. This traverse is a open traverse. To know this position of the traverse, location of the line, you have to know the angles. And how you are going to measure the angles, or how you have measured the angles in diploma level by using instrument, whether you have used prismatic compass or second you have used the theodolite. Because theodolite and prismatic compass are two instruments which can use for measurement of angles. And if people have used prismatic compass, then you have find out, then you have find out the angles, and then by pole bearing, back bearing, you have calculated the local attraction in which line. Then you have divided the error into all lines, and then you have said this traverse is free from local attraction. Okay, this process already you have done, and these are the methods of surveying. Based upon classification, methods of surveying, there are two methods of surveying. First is the triangulation, and second is the traversing. And by using these two methods, you can calculate the areas, or you can locate the various objects on the map. There are various objects on the ground surface that you can locate on the map. And last is the purpose. For which purpose you are going to guide out the survey? Archaeological survey, sir. Okay? Geological purpose, sir. Civilian purpose, sir. Military purpose, sir. Okay? So for various purposes, if you are going to carry out the survey, that survey is based upon the purposes or the uses. So this is the surveying classification. Primary classification, secondary classification, primary plain and geodetic, secondary based upon the type of instrument, nature of work, methods, and last is the purpose. Important thing is here, you have to know principle of triangulation. What is traversing? Traversing is the principle of compass. Two chapter already you have studied in diploma, that is chain surveying and compass surveying. And principle of chain surveying is a traversing. And principle of compass, principle of the compass is a traversing. And these are the methods of survey. Whatever the survey you are going to carry out, you are going to use these two methods. Okay? So this is about the classification. And next is a very important thing is a principle of surveying. What is principle of surveying? Like we have seen the what is principle of compass surveying, what is principle of chain surveying. So you have to know what is principle of the subject surveying. What is principle of the subject surveying? There are two principles of surveying. Which two principles? Always work from whole to part. And second, locate a new point position at least by taking the two measurements. Whether it is angular or whether it is linear. Okay, so principle first is always work from pole to part. And second is locate new points at least by taking two measurements.
whether it is angular or linear. So this is principle of the survey. Now what is exactly meaning of always work from whole to part? What is meaning of this? Means whenever you are going to work, suppose you have decided that I am going to work within this area. So first always you have to mark the boundary. And within that boundary you have to work. That is meaning always work from whole to part. Means you are not going to start work from small to large. Always you have to decide your final boundary and within that boundary you have to work. And when you are going to finalize the boundary, that work is your whole work, and then you are going to come to, you are going to work within that area. That is always work from whole to part. Means example for this, suppose I am going to measure one line on ground and I want to measure this line. The location or position of this line I don't know. Okay, just I am going to mark first distance 0 to 100 meter. Means I am going to take 100 meter tape and I am going to mark distance 100 meter. And then I am going to mark in this various chains. Okay, 10 meter, 20 meter, 30 meter, 40 meter, 50 meter, 60 meter, like this up to 100 meter. Okay, and what I have done here? What I have done here? Initially I have marked the 100 meter line. And then in within that, I am marking the Fourier change. What happened initially, which thing I have done? I have worked first whole. Then I have worked part. I have divided the area. Second thing, if you are going to work from part to whole means, I have to measure same line. Okay, near to this line, again I am going to mark the second line. And in that line, suppose I have given you a 5 meter tape instead of 100 meter tape. Getting instead of 100 meter tape, I have given a 5 meter tape and I asked measure this line by using 5 meter tape. What you are going to do here? You are going to take one line 5 meter, second line 5 meter, third line 5 meter, 5 meter, 5 meter, 5 meter, 5 meter. So you are going to get at least last 100 meter from 0 meter. What is quality of work? What is quality of work? Because initially you people know where you are going, and whatever the initially the error which you have done, that error is going to get large. The chote chote me error, the small error. Same way, if you are going to start from small to large, small means thoda error zara, to error kya mare pura kaam karta na bada bada zara pura. So that's why you have always have to. You are not always, you are going to work from part to whole. Means you have to finalize the first area where you are going to work, and within that area you are going to work. In that case, the error of chances is minimized here. Error dena hai samajh nahi, error dena. But compared to this, error is very less. That's why the principle of surveying is always work from whole to part. And for oral exam, external, or I am going to ask the same question like this, because you are going to study the surveying subject, you have to know the principle of surveying. The subject survey, the surveying subject, sheet time, the cursory sheet time, what are the principle of surveying that you have to know? Objective, you know, prepare the maps. What are the relative positions of the earth surface that you have to take on the map by measuring the horizontal distances, vertical distances, and angle. Yes, come back to the survey. Horizontal distance, vertical distances, angle. Hey, you have to survey what you can. And the angular distance measure to kya karache, that point position you have to take on the map. Okay? And that map you are going to use for the various military purposes. Next, locate new point, at least by taking the two measurements. Means if you are going to locate any point, you have to take the two measurements. Or you are going to tell the people the position of point is this. Already I have told you, I am standing here. I cannot say people that I am starting from this door 10 meter. Okay, people can take 10 meter at 90 degree, at 40 degree, at 30 degree, at 45 degree, at 60 degree. You have to tell people, I am standing from this door at 10 meter and angle of 90 degree. Then when exact position people are going to know. Same way, if you are going to
point, or if you are going to mark any point on the ground surface, then in that case, you have to at least give the two measurements. Two measurements means you can give the one angular, one linear, or one two angulars. Means suppose I am going to stand here, I am looking at from that corner I am standing 45 degree, from that corner I am standing 45 degree. So my position will easily located. In that case, if I am going to know the two angles. Or someone saying that I am standing from this, from 4 meter, and from this one, 1 meter, I can get the easily position. Means to locate the any new point, at least you have to take the two measurements, whether it is in form of two angles or two linear dimensions. Linear dimensions is what? Linear dimension means whether it is horizontal distance or vertical distance. So you can get the easily position of the new point. So this is about the principle of the surface. Okay? Before going to start surveying, you people thoroughly should know this. Why we are studying surveying? What is purpose? What is principle? And for which purpose we are studying? As a civil engineer, already I have told you, before going to start any subject, you have to ask this faculty, why we are studying this subject? What is purpose of studying this subject? I have already told you, university has set the various course objective or a program objective, where university is going to design the program for 4 years. Okay, university given certain the course objective. Okay, program outcomes. So, like that way, you people should know what is outcome of this subject. When I am going to study the surveying work, at last, which thing I am going to get? मी 6 महिने जर सब्जेक्ट स्टडी केला इथं मी 4 महिने स्टडी केला ते शिकल्यानंतर मला काय मिळणार आहे हे जर पहिले माहीत असेल तर मला इंटरेस्ट त्यामध्ये गेलो की मला कसं शिकायचं पण हेच माहीत नसेल मला कसं शिकायचं तर इंटरेस्ट झिरो आणि ऑलरेडी आय टोल्ड यू इफ यू आर गोइंग टू टेक इंटरेस्ट ऑल थिंग इज इंटरेस्टिंग इफ यू आर नॉट इंटरेस्टेड नथिंग इज इंटरेस्टिंग इट इज अप टू यू पीपल हाउ यू आर गोइंग टू इंटरेस्टेड ऑर यू आर इंटरेस्ट to study the subject or to see the, listen to the subject or to listen to the faculty and get the knowledge. Okay? So initially, always you have to know before going to study any subject, why you are studying this subject, okay, and what is purpose or objective. And then, after getting why I am studying this subject, then I can start with the knowing the various things about that subject. Kalasagana? So this is the initial part of the surveying. After this now, we are going to come to our syllabus. So syllabus, already I have told you, there are 6 units, 3 units in first section, 3 units in the second section. First unit is a leveling. What do you mean by leveling? Already I have told you, what is leveling? The art of determining the relative positions of different points by measuring the vertical distance between them. Okay, it is called as a leveling. Why to carry out the leveling? What is the purpose of leveling? Or objective of leveling? What is the objective of leveling?
To know the profile of ground.
To profile of the ground, correct? In this chapter, initially we are going to see now. Definition. Objective and then technical terms. Definition already you know now. Okay? Measuring two vertical distances related to each other point and that and then objective. What is objective or use? Why you have to carry out surveying? So first use of a surveying to prepare the contour maps. Okay? The use of objective or leveling is to prepare the contour maps. You know contour maps? What is contour line? Definition of contour line. A line which is passing from the same equilateral. Okay, that line is a contour line. When I am going to know the contour map, and based upon the contour map, I can identify what is profile of the ground. Means the profile of contour line is like this. Or profile of contour line
is like this. And we find out the RLs. 100, 90, 80, 100, 80, 100, 90, 100, 80, 100, 80. Like this, if I am going to know the contour map, as a civil engineer, if I am going to see the contour maps, just upon that contour map, easily I can understand what is profile of the ground. That is skill of a civil engineer. Okay? Jekada project was started crisis and also, Gudla Dreka, district for the dam cluster crisis and also, dam cluster crisis and you have to search the survey, and if people are going to do any survey, you have to see the contour map of that area. And based upon that contour map, you people have to identify what is profile of the ground. Just like you have to do 50 km area like a survey guys, and it's other than the car is going to be level of the ground. The 50 km you have to do the ground is like a side profile like a car is going to be. For that, you have to go to government in the department. Okay, in government, and then you are going to take the contour maps, and by studying the contour maps, easily you can identify what is profile of the ground. And based upon that profile of the ground, you can calculate the quantity of water going to store or volume of the water in that area. You can study what is catchment area, what is slope of area. Okay, but when you are going to know the catchment area is this much, volume of this much, slope of this much, based upon the contour lines, or based upon the contour lines. What is this indicate? Hill area. Okay. Suppose. Simple thing. Okay. This is, if I am going to see this hill area, okay, in section, the area of this point is 100. And what is contour line? The line passing point of equal elevations. Alright. If you have a line, you have 100, 100, so you have to circle. If you have a line, you plan to see it. 99, you are going to see it like this. 89, you are going to see it like this. So, in contour plan, you are not going to see these sections. You can see only this thing. But by seeing the readings or by seeing the contour map, you can identify this is the hill. Okay? Higher value inside the loop, it indicates the hill. And suppose lower value inside, it indicates the value. Which is opposite of the sky. It's not going to be. So we want to try to say 80. कारण आरएम म्हणजे काय उंची पर्यंत मेजर करायचे ही असेल तर इथं खाली असतं 80 असणार हे 90 असेल त्या साईडला 100 असेल ओके सो हियर 80 90 अँड 100 अँड वेन इन लूप लोअर व्हॅल्यू इन साइड और आरएम लोअर व्हॅल्यू इन साइड द लूप मॅक्सिमम आरएम आउटसाइड इट इंडिकेट्स इट इज हिट सेम इट इज सर दिस इज मी इथे 100 आहे 80 म्हणजे काय आहे स्लोप कसा बघा हा पार्ट बघा इकडचा पार्ट आहे असं स्लोप या साइड का स्लोप है इकडे पण वर है म्हणजे चार ठिकाणी लेवल पार्ट आहे आणि मध्ये काय दरी असले सर गेटिंग काय होतं हियर 180 आणि समजा इकडे 70 असेल हे 70 असेल 70 असेल तर कसं झालं स्लोप कसा या साइडला वर है आणि पण कमी कमी होत चालले चारी साइडला ओके इन फोर साइड इलेवेटेड पार्ट इज देयर इलेवेटेड पार्ट च्या मध्ये म्हणजे काय आहे इट इज सर सर म्हणजे दरी असले सर तुम्हाला So you people should know what is profile of the ground by seeing this contour maps. How you are going to get the contour maps? Contour map question by tumhala, how you are going to know the contour lines? Contour lines you are going to get by doing the leveling. That's why I am telling the objective or use of a leveling to prepare the contour maps. And contour maps are used tumhala sangitla. So tumhala location ekada area cha mala प्रोफाइल करावं तर तिथं कमी काय करू शकतो पाण्याची लाईन सेट करायची मला टेडी लाईन सेट करायची किंवा मला डॅम कस्ट करायचं आहे रिझर्व वाईज करायचं आहे बॅरियर करायचं आहे रेल्वे ट्रॅक ट्रॅक करायचे बिफोर गोइंग टू कन्स्ट्रक्ट द एनी सिव्हिल इंजिनिअरिंग स्ट्रक्चर यू पीपल शुड नो व्हॉट इज प्रोफाइल ऑफ द ग्राउंड अँड टू नो द प्रोफाइल ऑफ अ ग्राउंड इट इज अ मस्ट दॅट यू हॅव टू कॅरी आउट द लेवलिंग लेवलिंग म्हणजे काय टू गेट द रिलेटिव्ह पोझिशन्स ऑफ द डिफरंट पॉइंट
take the purlines up to prepare the contour maps. And by using the contour map, you can calculate the capacity of water in the dam, reservoir, barriers, and you can get the profile of the ground. Same way, second use of a leveling to know the altitude in a hilly area. Altitude म्हणजे काय सांगतो तुम्हाला, distance measured from mean sea level, altitude in hilly area. Hilly area मध्ये जर तुम्हाला altitude माहित करायचं असेल, so for that purpose also you are going to carry out the surface leveling. Leveling म्हणजे काय करायचं तुम्हाला, फक्त दोन पॉइंट मधला vertical distances काढत जायचे. ते म्हणजे काय झाली प्रोसेस लेवलिंग. पहिला यूज, what is use of objective? To prepare the contour maps. Second use, to know the altitudes in hilly area. Hilly area with the altitude, what is the samudra sapati pasun cha distance, vertical distance. Third use, what is third use? To fix the layout for water supply and the sediments. Getting already I'm told you, if I'm going to construct the pipeline for Solapur city from Uzni, first I am going to see whether it is possible or not. Already I have told you this thing to you people. When I am going to construct the water, drinking water line for two cities, which thing first I have to know? Kaya bhai dhaya bhai? Slope means profile of the ground. Ground sa nature kasa hai. Okay, so suppose Solapur is here and Uzni is here. And someone is telling me layout the water supply line from Solapur to Uzni. In this case, I am going to start that person. Which thing I am going to do that person? It is possible to connect the or provide the water from Solapur Uzni to Solapur, or it is not possible? Why you are telling not possible? Because I have marked the position of Solapur upside and Uzni downside. If suppose I am going to mark the position of Solapur here, what is your answer? Yes. But these positions are very important. Getting? And this position is nothing but the profile of the ground. Without profile of the ground, तुम्ही तुम्हाला काय सांगितलं नाही. मी सांगितलं की सोलापूर इथं आहे, उजनी इथं आहे का नाही. इट इज पॉसिबल टू प्रोव्हाइड द वॉटर सप्लाय ऑर नॉट. तुमचा आंसर काय असणार याच्यामध्ये? सांगू शकत नाही. कारण पाणी कसं आहे किंवा कुठं जास्त हिल आहे, कुठल्या साईडला कमी आहे ते मला माहित नाही. त्यासाठी मला पहिले काय करावं लागेल? सर्वे करायला. सर्वे म्हणजे काय होणार? लेवल बघणार. आणि ते तुमचं पहिले काम आहे लेवलिंग. तुम्ही जो प्रोफाईल ऑफ द ग्राउंड अँड द मोमेंट इफ आय एम गोइंग टू नो द प्रोफाईल ऑफ सोलापूर हियर, उजनी हियर, सो आय कॅन टेल पीपल ओके वी कॅन लेवल द पाइपलाइन हियर अँड थ्रू ग्रॅव्हिटी वी कॅन प्रोव्हाइड द वॉटर टू द सोलापूर सिटी. And if it is not possible, suppose Solapur city is here, then in this case, you have to give the alternate solution. Means, you have to construct the tunnel. Or underground water pipeline, you have to construct. Or second option, you have to take water by electricity. The gravity flow is the one that the company pumps to the one. And for that, you have to give amount also. What is construction of laying the pipeline? So maintenance guy, how you are going to carry out the water, what is electricity bill to take this water from Uzni to Solapur, and what is the economy of that project. Okay, and as a civil engineer, you have to work or you have to achieve the economy. The economy is important. But that's a little bit of the skill. And skill mother, you have to know the various profile of the ground, and then and then only you can give the solutions. Okay? To supply or to fix the or to lay the water line or drainage line, in that case you can use the leveling also. So leveling sa upyog kay mala sanat mala ba ni kaam ke to know the profile of ground. The sara kuch kya sir contour plan mujhe kya hai ground se profile kaise altitude of from hilly area mujhe ground kya hai to construct the water supply and sanitary line mujhe tela slope paise mujhe ground se profile paise. And lastly is to prepare the cross sectional or longitudinal section for the road or railway project. Getting? Last use is to prepare the longitudinal section and the cross sections for the road and railway lines. What do you mean by longitudinal section? Any section is taken along the length. That's actually called as a longitudinal section. and cross section, any section taken perpendicular to the length. That section is a cross section of the travel, cross section, okay, cross section. Okay, by, so what are the use of what learning, what uses, measure uses? First is a, to prepare the better map. Second, to know the altitudes in a hilly area. Third use, to lay out the water supply line and the surrounding line. And third use is the, to prepare the longitudinal section for road and railways or the cross sections. There has to be traverse section motion, sorry, transverse section motion. Okay, now why would you require the longitudinal section and cross section for the road in Lowly? To know the exact quantity of earthwork. If you are going to the longitudinal section of the road, longitudinal section means what? You are going to cut the road along the length. And if you are going to cut the road along the length, you are going to know every exact profile of the ground here. If profile of the ground is like this, and you are going to construct the road here, you have to suggest the which line? Formation line. Formation line is a road like this. And then before going to fix the formation line, you people should know profile of the ground. And based upon that profile, you can suggest the formation line. And you are going to suggest the formation line is based upon the quantity of earthwork. Means you cannot cut the whole section. Means if you are going to suggest the formation line here, what happened? Major part is a cutting part, minor part is a filling part. So if you are going to cut this part, okay, the amount you are going to spend for cutting this, is too large. Plus cutting plus, you have to transport this material into other side. If somebody profile up like this, I am going to suggest like this road like this. What happened in this case? What happened in this case? Whatever the material I am going to excavate here, that material I am going to put here. Whatever the material I am going to excavate here, that I am going to put here. So that balance you have to get. And after putting or after finalizing the formation level, you can suggest the what is cost of the road. This is one more thing compared to the IRB assessed. Okay, whatever the Pune Highway, so whatever Pune Highway constructed by the IDNFS company. Now they have not got this contract. Utla contract, Solapur to it. Ha National Highway, Atana Mehanakuna Mala, IRB Lata. Okay, so initially those people have to give estimate of the road. And it is in thousands of crore. And that thousands of crore, in that you are going to achieve the economy based upon one thing, and that is a formation line. How engineer is going to suggest the formation line, that is very important. If the formation line is wrong or it is uneconomical, in that case, the project is going to give the going to face the huge cost. And if you want to compare it to the four companies of tender, you will have to tender and how you are going to achieve economy, that is your skill. But what thing, for that thing, which thing you require? Make an answer to them. ये कटिंग फिलिंग में कहाँ डिसाइड कर कर एक असल में कहा है कि कटिंग इधर करो फिलिंग इधर करो बेस्ट ऑफ ऑन द प्रोफाइल ए प्रोफाइल में अंदर वाली प्रोफाइल मींस आई एम गोइंग टू नो द आरएल जेजे आरएल का शंकर माइंस है हेचे आरएल 90 है हेचे आरएल ए शे का हेचे आरएल 101 पर समथिंग है हेचे आरएल 102 है हेचे आरएल 97 है व्हाट आर द रिड्यूस लेवल आफ्टर गेटिंग ऑल रिड्यूस लेवल आई कैन ड्रॉ द लॉन्जिट्यूडनल क्रॉस सेक्शंस एंड दैट इज यूज ऑफ द लिंक का लिंक यूज है to prepare the longitudinal section and the transverse section for the road to get the exact quantity of earthwork. Earthwork means what? The material uses. Okay, so this is, these are the four uses of the leveling. Definition you know? I recommend the leveling positions of different points by measuring the vertical distance between them. And then objective, first objective, prepare the contour maps. Second objective, to know the altitudes in the hill area. Third is to construct the water supply line or drainage line. And fourth objective use is to prepare the longitudinal sections and the transverse section forward to know the exact quantity of earthwork. Okay, so these are the main two things in the leveling. Initial point, definition and the objective. Why you have to study the leveling? After learning, you should know, or you should, people know how to draw the contour map. Use is the, use kya tha mujhe? Tumhe this kya hai? But haan, topic shikha nantar. After completion of this unit, I should know how to draw the contour line. How to know the profile of the ground. How to lay out the, how to know the slope of the ground. And how to decide whether I am going to provide water supply line or drainage line. Okay, the objective जब तुम्हारा साथ देने से था, तब तुम्हें शिक्षण का उपयोग नहीं हुआ। मुझे चाहता तुम्हें शिक्षण पसंद है का उपयोग नहीं। And initially I have told you, you have to sit here to know what are the concept. Me suppose if I am going to start today unit leveling, तुम जो मनोमति कहाँ बचे बोले अंदर घुस गया? That in upcoming this 10 lecture or 12 lecture of ours, I am going to thoroughly understand what is concept of leveling. And if tomorrow I am going to work on some site, tomorrow if I am going to start working on some survey site, in that case my concept is clear. I am not saying that you are going, you are visiting on site first day and you should know all things. It is not possible. Okay? Because theory part is different and practical part is different. But practical is related with the theory concepts. Totally different as a guy must have done. Concept are same. The method is different, but concept are same. But if people are strong in concept, in that case, it is well achieved. Okay? So this is about the objective. Today we are going to stop here. Next lecture, we are going to see the various technical terms used in a learning. Okay? So we are going to stop here.